All right, I'm so excited. He is the go-to guy for celebrities looking to get in shape, but he doesn't just work with the rich and famous. Jorge Cruz has changed the lives of millions of people as a health coach, personal trainer, and best-selling author. He joins us to talk about his new book, The Cruz Control Diet, which is number one.
Number one in nutrition right now.
Congratulations.
And it just came out last Tuesday. I was in New York in Times Square at one of the shows out there, and one show popped it, and I'm just so thrilled because, you know, today's world, 91% of us suffer with belly fat.
Right.
And it connects to diabetes, heart disease, aging. Mm-hmm. So it's an issue, and hopefully we can reveal some of the secrets.
Here's what you got me. You got me at hello when you said you can lose a pound a day.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
Well, we talk on the cover of the book how you can lose up to 28 pounds in 28 days. And so I've been a trainer now for 25 years. I started with Tony Robbins back in 93, 94.
And he's on the back of the book, right?
Yeah, no, he wrote the introduction to my very first book. I've written over 30. And in this crazy career of mine, I've been on shows. I've met everyone from Oprah, President Clinton. I've worked with everyone. Brooke Burke is one of my dearest clients in Malibu, Steve Harvey. And what I've discovered out of everything I've learned out of training and nutrition, intermittent fasting, the word fasting, it's kind of a term that people are talking about, is the most powerful way to transform health, lose weight. But here's the catch. Most of my clients, I remember Steve Harvey, he's like, Jorge, I'm gonna be hungry, you know?
Right.
And you are, because,
tough.
You know? And so what I had to do is take that, and this is a spin of intermittent fasting. Okay. I call it cruise control fasting. Mm-hmm. It's a hashtag, it's a whole movement. We have a website, cruisecontrolfasting.com. And what it does is it helps people cheat the fast, so you never feel hungry, and that way you can do it. It's a 16-hour window where you don't eat, but we cheat it, and you know, you can have your water to hydrate, but you can have coffees, lattes, with healthy fats.
All right, you talked about this, and I've heard this before, and I've always been really confused about this, but one of the ways you cheat the system is coffee with butter.
It could be tea too, but yeah, basically what Brooke does, and she's one of my dearest friends and clients in Malibu, and she's 48, we're both 48. She's running around Malibu, you guys know, in a bikini, mother of four, and I love Brooke, there we are. That's in Arizona. We do a lot of videos together, and she keeps this body rocking. She wrote the introduction to the book, but here's what she does. We do grass-fed butter in the morning.
Okay.
We sometimes will add a little MCT oil and sometimes heavy cream, not half and half. It has half sugar and not milk because it's all sugar.
Right.
And so if you can do that, guess what the fat does? It's the only macronutrient because it's protein, carbs that raise insulin, but fat doesn't have an effect on insulin. And if you don't raise insulin, guess what your body is, it's not dumb, but it doesn't know that you're eating. And so you turn off hunger and you're still fasting.
Right.
So you're still burning belly fat. And this thing in science called autophagy occurs where you also kind of do housekeeping in your body.
Right.
So it removes old cells. So it disease-proofs your body too.
There are a lot of benefits, by the way. Look it up for intermittent fasting. Yeah. But what about all that fat? Doesn't it go to your heart, all that saturated fat?
Well, so, you know, and I worked with President Clinton for many years after he had his quadruple bypass. Mm-hmm. And he was a vegan for many years. And I was at a dinner party with him in New York City. And he finally started eating meat again because the science has shown that dietary cholesterol does not impact blood serum cholesterol. That's more of a myth. And what the science shows now, it's more sugar, hate to say it, like orange juice in the morning, that can raise cholesterol more because it spikes your liver.
What are the biggest mistakes that you see people make? That they think they're doing something good, you know, and they're really...
Well, and I want to tell everyone watching, it's not our fault, because in 1906, I talk about this in the book, the good old Dr. Harvey Kellogg, do you remember Sarah Jessica Parker's husband, Matthew Broderick?
Yeah.
He played Harvey Kellogg like 20 years ago in a movie where he invented the cornflake. And this is in 1906. So in 1906, to sell his cornflakes, he created a word that was never in existence in America.
Okay.
It was called breakfast. In 1905, that word didn't exist.
Breaking the fast.
And it is the most important meal of the day, because back before 1905, most Americans, we were lucky to have one good meal.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, think of the disciples at the Last Supper. They had one meal a day. Mm-hmm. Think of the Romans. Think of throughout history.
Right.
We usually had one good meal, because what did we have to do all day? Yeah. We had to hunt and gather things.
Yeah.
Right.
And most people in Malibu that I work with, like celebrities, Brooke was one of them. She thought she couldn't even teach her booty burn class without passing out. Now, we fast through the workout, she doesn't have lunch till maybe 12 or 1 o'clock, and she'll have like cruise control coffee or tea, and then we have hacks at night. We have the recipe, the book has 50 recipes with chocolate mousse that you can make with heavy cream. Again, we're using heavy fat, but this is natural fat, you know, natural fat. turns off like a switch, hunger. So you don't feel, it's like Thanksgiving, you're stuffed, and then your body taps into the stored belly fat, autophagy occurs, so you look gorgeous, age proofs your body, diabetes. I mean, within the first week, most people lose 7 pounds.
Let me, a quick question.
Yeah.
If you were to do the intermittent fasting,
yeah, yeah,
and then you have a night where, like
right,
tonight,
yep,
I'm going out with somebody.
Right.
It's perfect.
And
yeah,
I would completely blow it. Is okay?
No, you won't blow it, because here's what you do. I teach people in the book on page 46 how to adjust your fasting window. So say you're gonna go out, and I have, you know, I'm a single dad, I have two beautiful kids. I'll do dinner sometimes 8 or 9 when I'm not with my kids. Mm-hmm. And so if I'm going out late, and you can drink wine on this plan.
Yeah.
I drink tequila shots.
Excellent.
We do wine. You
okay,
can. You just have to do it within an 8-hour window. So if you're going out, what time is dinner tonight?
Like 9 or 10? 7:15.
And you may drink until maybe later.
Well him, 2 a.m., 3 a.m.
2 a.m. <Okay. laughs>
He'll roll right
to
in.
To be determined.
You know? So then I would probably wait to have lunch till maybe 2 or 3, have a later lunch, and then you just do more of these coffees and beverages. And then if it's so long it's in your 8-hour window, you can drink alcohol. You can eat pizza. We have pasta. We have recipes in here how to modify it so it's more anti-inflammatory.
Wow.
With like cauliflower rice and cauliflower pizza. But you can drink real wine. You can do tequila shots. You can still do that. You just have to adjust your eating window. So by 2 a.m. you're stopped. You know, you got to stop eating.
You got to stop at some point, Frank.
This is really interesting.
Yeah,
thank
yeah
you so much.
And it works
much
brilliantly. For,
thank you.
For emotional right leaders, too. It really does.
Okay. The Cruise Control
right
Diet
you,
is available now. For more information, head on over to JorgeCruz.com.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Jorge.
Thank you, guys.
Love
thank
talking
you guys
to you.
You can do it, guys.
All right, thanks.